It certainly is, and according to Slidell police, Joshua Cox, who lives just outside the city limits, shot his wife, killed a man he carjacked, then got into a fight with an associate who ended up shooting and killing Cox, ending a one-man crime spree. This all happened after Cox's mother died of an apparent drug overdose. Police Chief Randy Fandel said an unfortunate series of events led to the death of three people in Slidell. Fandel claims this man, 29-year-old Joshua Cox, went on a one-man violent crime spree after learning his mother died from a drug overdose last Thursday night.
All of this started over drugs, which led to bad, irrational decisions being made by Cox.
According to Slidell police, Cox's mother OD'd at a home on Gwen Drive around 10:15 the night of November 8th. Cox asked his wife to drive him to the hospital to see his mother. Police say while on the way to the hospital, Cox and his wife got into an argument and he shot her once in the chest. Cox then dropped his wife off at Slidell Memorial Hospital and took off. Around midnight, Cox encounters 38-year-old Christopher Evans working on his girlfriend's white Chevy Tahoe in the 1500 block of Queens Drive in Slidell. Police say Cox ditched his car, shot Evans in the head, killing him, and stole the Tahoe with Evans' body inside the vehicle. From there, police say Cox headed to New Orleans.
During the investigation, we know that Cox has traveled into some other drug-related areas with the body in the car.
Around 4:30 the morning of November 9th, police responded to a report of shots fired at an apartment complex on Lee Street in Slidell. Police say Cox got into a fight with 26-year-old Jameel Robinson, who lives at the complex. Robinson shot and killed Cox during the fight. Police say Cox went to Robinson's apartment to rob or kill him, and that Robinson shot Cox in self-defense. Robinson was arrested for allegedly having drugs and a firearm in his apartment. Police also found Evans' dead body in the Tahoe in the parking lot of the complex. Slidell Mayor Greg Cromer says this type of crime is not typical for his North Shore community.
We had three homicides to this point in this year. This has doubled our number for the year.
Joshua Cox had a long rap sheet, according to police, which included both drug charges and violent crimes. And police say that Cox's wife is still in the hospital tonight, but is expected to recover.